We got the doors wide open, the fans going wide open. So we'd like to take the floor from Squamish. We appreciate that. And warm the drum. Roll the drum, excuse me. To Warm Springs, Warm Springs. You have the floor, Warm Springs. Thank you. Awesome.
Check, check. Check, check.
Check.
Check, check. Nihlawit in Mima Naimuma Kukotwaima. Good evening, our relatives and friends. We've traveled here from the great Columbia River. We are Inchiwanapum and the Clatsop Nehalem. We also have the Palouse tribe with us, who is on their way to getting their first canoe. And so the three of us are here together. And if you don't mind, we're gonna limit our talking because we just wanna jam. Thank you. So as we're getting warmed up here, for these three next songs, these very three in particular next songs, there should be no recording, no videotape, and no pictures, please. Videos, whatever. Facebook the heck out of this one. You might as well text everybody and tell them this is one chance. All these guys on the floor, a lot of them, and even up here, this is the first time we've ever done protocol. So we appreciate the encouragement. So again, we are representatives of the Columbia Plateau and all those tribes. And so all of these songs have been gifted to the people of the plateau by the animals. So believe it or not, we didn't compose these dances, and they're shared with all the tribes of the plateau. So you can go to Yakima, Colville, Umatilla, Lapway, Warm Springs, and they do these same dances because the animals gifted them to us all, and all of our tribes share these resources and songs and teachings. And so we were not gonna say these are our dances because they belong to the people, just as the animal gave them to us. So here is our four winds. It'll take every direction together. Our men will half moon it. And this is all of our tribes coming together.
Hey,
that one was our... So that one was our river and water dance. Taking the water from the sky, cherishing the water from the sky, and cherishing the water from the earth. And that's what the dance is all about.
Thank you.
So just a bit of symbolism in that as I'm explaining the song. You're welcome to bring some of the little ones out to join our boys in this bear dance. Long story short, old legend has it that the bears, when all the animals were no longer able to relate to the humans because of how much deceit and how angry and how unrespectful the humans were to each other, we lost touch with the animals. But during that time, the animals still yearned to have a relationship with the humans. And all these animals, they came to join these humans down in the Columbia Gorge, having this big old gathering. And it had all these animals, the elk, the snake, the deer, the cougars, the rabbits. And all of them decided they're gonna go down as one, just as all of us as people should be as one. All these animals came down as one. And when they got down to the gathering, they all got so shy, they didn't know which animal was gonna go first. All of them looked at each other and said, I don't have a dance. Well, you don't have a dance. And the bears looked at each other and said, hey, we got a dance. And this is how it looked, and this is how they walked into that circle. So just an explanation about our whip man and our whip woman. So back at home where we're from, it's still really strict in our homes. And we still have whip men and whip women, and they have to keep all our dancers in line. But the short story behind our whip man and that dance in particular is a long time ago, the eagle was observing all of these people fighting for resources, fighting for gifts and for land. And so the eagle came down and gifted its bone and said, you're going to use this bone as a whip to keep all of these young ones in line so that they know how to conduct themselves when they get older. And so if any of you guys would like to bring this back in your own personal families, you're welcome to go ahead and start whipping them around so they quit littering our earth, quit drinking around, quit smoking around, just whip them around.
Oh!
That right there is our swan dance. And this right here is our root digging and berry dance. So when all those bears took the floor and showed all those animals and all those humans that they knew how to dance, then all these other animals said, well, I have a dance too, and I have a dance too, and I have a dance. And that's when they shared all these dances with us, and that's why we do them. So this is what the bunny hop, the bunnies gave us.
Hey, oh, 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 hey, oh
So, as the girls are getting ready, long story short, sorry I gotta cut these stories short, by the way. In our teachings, we were always taught that legends are actually told in the wintertime, many, many years ago. And that if you told them during the off time, when the sun is out, when everyone is supposed to be gathering so that they can take care of each other, that's why they don't tell legends when the sun is out. But in the old days, they told legends in the winter, and that's why I cut these stories short. But this song right here is a mourning song and about a woman who lost her husband. And in the midst of her mourning, after she got into the cocoon, or as she got in the canoe and floated down the mighty Columbia River, it became a cocoon. And when it blossomed, she became a beautiful butterfly. Next song, down on the mighty Columbia River, all the tribes of the mighty Columbia River still fish off of scaffolds, and even our fishermen are even here on this floor. And so this dance is representation of the dip nets and them fishing off of the scaffolds.
Kishon.
Come out and join our dancers. Before you take your seats, we'd like all the girls to please stay on the floor. All the girls. And at this time, if there's any other girls, do you see your sister, do you see your cousin, all of the daughters, come on out to the floor. And I'd like to first introduce the composer, Mr. Corey Cuyapama.
Good evening, Tribal Journeys. Thank you for having us. Thank you for staying here and listening and supporting our family. But right here, I got my daughter. It's our first journey. Her name is Layla Cuyapama. And a song came to me, and I made it for her, and it's from Daddy. And I'd like all the daughters to come out here and join her. So if you guys could just come help us out, I'd like this whole floor filled. We don't need formation, just fill it up.
Dakota.
So, The dance is very simple and very honorable and very graceful. So I'd like Inchiwanapum's lead dancers to raise your hands. Our four lead dancers. Thank you. All you have to do is watch one of them girls, and you'll be all right.
Oh!
to thank everybody who came out and danced. I'd just like to give you the meaning of that song. It means, beautiful little daughter, I love you with all my heart. And that's for Layla Quiapama there. It's her first journey.
So our very first journey was Journey 2010, Journey to Macaw. It was an honor, a blessing. And since that time, we've grown to have relationships with so many tribes that our youth would have never had the chance to ever meet. And for even us as adults, we had never been to Macaw or Lower Elwha or Pillar Point or Jamestown or Suquamish, Tulalip, like never in our lives until all of these youth and these adults that are here on the floor started this canoe family and said, we're just gonna do it. The canoe was pretty much placed in their lap and we've just carried it on. So in this time, we've been gifted and now share songs with tribes. So at this time, we'd like to call out lead singers for the Cowlitz tribe, the Swinomish tribe, and the Quinault tribe. Lead singers for those tribes. Because of the gifts that they've given to the Clatsop Nehalem tribes, and the Inchiwanapum canoe family of the mighty Columbia River that consists of many tribes. And we'll make do with what we got. What we usually say is we're just gonna wing it. Probably not on the water, but when we take protocol and when we come out the jam, we just say we're gonna wing it. So also the Cowlitz dancers, if you guys are here, you're welcome to come out and join us in the song. So these songs were gifted. The Quinault song was gifted to the Clatsop Nehalem tribe, specifically by Guy Kapoman. And the Cowlitz song was gifted to the Clatsop Nehalem and the Inchiwanapum, and so was the Swinomish song. So at this time, with all these tribes out here, this is unity, and we're gonna sing all these songs just as one unit and out of love and out of respect for each other. So first one we're gonna sing is with the one that Cowlitz gifted to us. Okay, so for the Cowlitz song, our younger boys start off the song. And our younger girls start off the song, and then we all chime in. So the tribes that gifted these songs, can we please make room in Chiwanapum for these other tribes to come in?
Thank you.
Hello?
The people would like to see the young lady.
Thank you, everybody.
My name is Jesse Tufty.
I'm Vera Lopez.
Again, if we have Quinault lead dancers or lead singers, please come join us for the next song for the gift that was given to the class of Nehalem.
Oh,
This next song is shared with the Quinaults, between the Quinaults and the Clatsop Nehalem. I'd like to call forth Charlotte Bash, as well as Quinaults.
Yeah.
Swinomish, Cowlitz, and Quinault for sharing your culture and your songs with the tribes that are currently on the floor. We love you. We love you. So at this time, I'd like to call up Charlotte and Lorraine Bash of the Clatsop Nehalem tribe, who have traveled with us since last year, and this year, they got to bring their dragonfly canoe made by Guy Kapoman.
We got Charlotte Bash Seed Stut, Klatsum Nehalem, Akwi Puyallapub Shud, to all Seaside, Oregon. Klatsum Nehalem Chuk, to all Clatsop County, to all Nehalem, Oregon. I'm Charlotte Bash. I'm Klatsum Nehalem and Puyallup. Today I'm here representing the Klatsop Nehalem. Last year we were able to join the Warm Springs Canoe family, and I can't express how much that means to us. The Klatsop Nehalem homelands are on the west coast of Oregon, the coast of Oregon. Our homelands are from Clatsop County into Nehalem. We signed the Tansy Point Treaties in 1851, and because those treaties were never ratified, us and many other tribes, including some that are here today, are still fighting for recognition. And so we're here today. Last year we had about four people, now we have a couple more, and even some that joined us and pulled along the journey that weren't able to make it today, that protocol. But the canoe journey really has helped us bring back our culture, and as you can see, we've made relations with everyone, like Warm Springs and Quinault and Cowlitz and many more, and we just want to thank everyone for that, and thank you for the canoe journey is really giving us a chance to find our culture again and bring it here to share with all of you. And every year we're going to be bringing back more and more. So thank you. And our chairwoman, Diane Collier, wants to say something really short, she
says. Very short. Squaxin Island, I want to thank you for this excellent play, and your homeland is absolutely beautiful. We've driven around and around and looked everything over. Thank you again. And thank you, Warm Springs, for doing what you've done for us for the last 2 years and allowing us to learn some of our culture. Thank you.
So at this time, as you guys have taught us to say, we'd love to take care of some business. And then we're actually gonna get back to jamming a little bit. Believe it or not, we've made it through 22 songs. I don't know how long we've been up here, but we still have 4 more hours to go. So, I'm just kidding.
How's everybody doing today? How are you guys doing? You guys enjoying this beautiful weather out here? Oh my goodness, it's wonderful. Like, no joke. Sorry about my voice, I sound like all crazy. On behalf of Nichi Wunnapum, we want to call upon one girl, one boy, youth of Squaxin. Please come forward.
Hello.
Doesn't matter who, just one boy, one girl.
From Squaxin.
This on behalf of Nichi Wunnapum and Clatsop of Halem. You guys enjoy these? We're gifting them a shirt and a necklace. And can we also have one youth of a boy and a girl from Muckleshoot, please, come down. All right, we got one. Woo! Can we also get a youth from Cowlitz? One boy and one girl, please. Can we also get one youth, one boy, one girl from Tulalip, please?
Mm-hmm.
I get one boy and one girl from Suquamish? Please. From Suquamish, can we get one boy, one girl, please? Can we get one boy, one girl youth for Suquamish, please?
Can we get one girl and one boy from Snohomish? Can I have the captains and skippers from Muckleshoot, Tulalip, Squaxin,
Snohomish,
Snoqualmie, and Cowlitz, please come up. Only one though, captain and skipper, please.
Thank you. one veteran from Muckleshoot, Tulalip, Snohomish. Snohomish, sorry. Snoqualmie, Cowlitz, and Squaxin, and Tulalip. And one elder man from Snohomish, Snoqualmie, Tulalip, Muckleshoot, Squaxin, and Cowlitz. Please. Can we have one elder woman from Snohomish? Oh, from all the tribes that we just said. Snohomish, Snoqualmie, Tulalip, Muckleshoot, Squaxin, and Cowlitz. Please.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming to the stage from the Columbia Plateau, an elder of all elders, wiser of the wisest, Mrs. Aurelia Stacona, ladies and gentlemen.
I want to thank the host. You folks have been wonderful. Your hospitality, I can't express. I just want to say that I'm sorry we took so long, and we need to use wisdom. I heard this morning that it's time for the elders to step back and to give to the youth the responsibility. And I watched the little boy that was receiving those canoes, and this is one thing that really touched me, to see that giving that responsibility to a youth and the teaching. Because truly the theme is teaching of our ancestors. And this is what I learned growing up from my ancestors. And the echo of the fall still rings in our spirit from the Wayam where we're coming from. And I again want to thank you and apologize for taking so long. And I know that there are other groups that's coming on, but we're thankful for the invitation, to extend that invitation. We are so thankful that we are here and made it here. I traveled all the way for a month with the group, and I just want to say again that I am so thankful. I can't begin to express my feeling. Thank you.
So, we'd like to have some of the youth come out on the dance floor. We'd like to share another song with you guys. This song was gifted to us by the Coyote many, many moons ago. In a lot of our teachings and ancestry, the Coyote has taught many, many things to the humans and to the other animals. Well, one of those things is to not take things for granted, for sure. But another one of those things is to always have a sense of humor. And if it's a harmless joke, don't take it personal. But the Coyote likes to play tricks, and this dance is about playing tricks. And it's been done for quite some time, and through our visits with elders, we were able to revive the dance. So do we have any more coyotes coming out? Let me hear some coyote howls. I still see coyotes coming out. Thank you all for coming out. So as you'll see in the dance, lead dancers, can you please just raise your hand? You don't have to go to the middle. Just raise your hand. Phoenix. Damien. Where's Whipman? All right. So as you'll see in the dance, the coyote's also playing bones in the game. And his hands are at his side, and he's playing bones, and he's in the game. But he also decides to change directions and go back the other way. So it's gonna go clockwise, counterclockwise, and just have fun with it. On three, let's hear everybody in the tent howl like that coyote. One, two, three. Thank you. You may have your seat now as we begin to take formation. And as we begin to close the floor, hey, just curious, is somebody missing a arrowhead with bone beads and red, white, and black beads and a gold bead in the middle?
Dance for it.
Ooh. Does it look like anybody's? Do we have to take a picture and post it on Facebook? Can you just claim it? We're going to turn it into the host tribe. And we have a dancer. So, before we go into our exit farewell dance, we'd actually like to kindly and honorably and sincerely ask permission if we may untie our canoe. And thank you so much, Squaxin Island, for your hospitality. We need a lot of exercise to burn off all these calories that you've given us. So, if there is a Squaxin Island representative here who'd like to give us permission to untie our canoe. Before you walk off.
Is that one working? Is this one working? Same thing, the dragonfly canoe from Clats of Nehalem would like to ask permission for or to leave. We've had an amazing time here and can't wait to eat some more and hear everyone's songs and dances.
Thank you.
So for this last song, we'd like to ask, kindly ask, for no pictures, no recording, no cameras for this last song.
Good evening, good evening. Let's give another round of applause to Warm Springs. Claps up. Nehalem, thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. There's been some rumors floating around, and they're according to these pages at the end that we're at the end of our day, but we're not. We're going to keep on rolling on. We're going to keep on rolling on. Things are going smoothly here today. Very smooth, and we're very fortunate for that.